गुड इवनिंग माय डियर किड्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक टू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ साइंस। आई एम मिथुन राज, साइनिंग इन फ्रॉम दिस पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, कोचिंग केरला, योर साइंस टीचर। माय डियर किड्स, एंड यू आर स्टडीइंग नाउ द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ 10th स्टैंडर्ड साइंस, द एनसीईआरटी साइंस, एंड द नेम इज एब्सोल्युटली एसिड्स, बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स। सो ऑलमोस्ट द मेन पार्ट ऑफ दैट चैप्टर ऑलरेडी वी कवर्ड। Now what is remaining? Only some application level questions, okay? Some applications of acids and bases in real life, and we will study about 5 salt, okay? Totally 5 salts are there. That is very important. Actually, it is very easy, very easy. Only 5 salts you want to study: the preparation, the uses, and the application. Okay, that's it. 5 salts are there, especially in this chapter. Starting from the common salt which we use in our daily life, washing soda, baking soda, baking powder, and plaster of Paris. Okay, these all are chemical salts. How they are produced, what are the uses of them, and in which places we are using all these salt, that is the main thing in this chapter. I hope that you already have a clear sense regarding acids and bases now, isn't it? Okay, it's not that much very difficult. So that knowledge you must apply now. Okay, that knowledge you must apply now. Simple common sense questions are there. If you think, you will be able to answer that. Okay, I will try to explain all the question answers right with this video. Okay, it's not a part of the textbook, but these are application level questions which will come for examinations. Okay, the first one. Yesterday we studied about what? We studied about, I think, pH and all, isn't it? Antacids and pH. You already know what is antacid, what is pH value and all. So the next one we are going to study, what is it? It is why our tooth or our teeth is decaying. Have you seen these, like, what do you say, decay of teeth in our mouth or tooth in our mouth? Anyway, most of the teenagers, they are suffering from this problem, okay? And your parents, every time they will tell, brush your teeth properly. What is the reason for that? Do you know? Because mostly the food we are eating, okay, the food we are eating, mostly it is acidic in nature. Understand? Okay, whenever we are cooking the food after cooking, its acidity will increase. Okay, the acidic nature of that food will increase. And there is a particular coating in our teeth, okay? There is a particular coating which gives that shininess to our teeth, isn't it? Our teeth are shiny or not? That particular coating is called as enamel, and it is the hardest matter in our body. Understand? Our human teeth is the hardest matter in our body. Even if millions of years, not millions, thousands of years after also, our teeth or tooth won't disintegrate. Our bones will disintegrate, our flesh will disintegrate, our hair will disintegrate, everything will disintegrate. The last thing to get disintegrate is our human tooth. Okay? So that tooth is covered with a particular material called as the enamel. Okay? This white coating of our teeth is called as enamel. But the food which we are eating contains acid in it. Let's see, tooth decay is the corrosion of the tooth enamel. You know, acid is corroding, isn't it? Acid will corrode materials. If you pour concentrated acid in our body will burn. If you pour concentrated acid into metals, it will react with the metals. Same thing is happening here. This acid will react with the enamel. Just see. Tooth decay is the corrosion of the enamel. Enamel is that white coating of teeth. Okay? White coating of teeth which gives that shininess to our teeth. When pH in the mouth is below 5.5, means acidic medium. No doubt about that. 5.5 means acidic. Below 7, everything is acidic. If the pH in our mouth is below 5.5, bacteria present in our mouth produce acids by degrading of sugar and food particles remaining in the mouth after eating. Why we are brushing the teeth, that we will discuss later. Anyway, after eating food, even if we clean our mouth, some, what you say, some debris of food, that small, small particles of food will be sticked here and there in our teeth, isn't it? Just after having a lunch, just check. You can see small, small particles of food which is sticking in the teeth. And already acid is present in the food we are eating, isn't it? So when we are eating this food, there's a lots of bacteria inside our mouth also. So these bacteria will produce acid by degrading sugar and food particles. They will degrade, they will use these food particles, and in that place what they will create? They will create acid. And this acid will react with our enamel, causing tooth decay. Now understand how our tooth is decaying. See how this is occurring. Because whenever we are eating food, and if the pH value of our mouth is below 5.5, what will happen? The bacteria present in our mouth, they will degrade the food particles. Okay, mostly sugar, sugar and fat in that food, and in that place they will produce acids, and acids will react with the tooth enamel, and it will cause corrosion. Actually, it is the corrosion of the teeth that is called as tooth decay. I will give the notes. It is very easy to understand the notes, but some extra thing like this enamel and the hardest thing, that is not in textbook, but it's a great general knowledge question. See, so how we can reduce the tooth decay? Anyway, the bacteria are producing acids, no doubt regarding that, isn't it? If they are producing acid, why we can't use a base to neutralize that, isn't it? So we use this toothpaste. Okay, the toothpaste which we are using, it is nothing but what? Basic in nature, okay? And all the other flavors and all, it is simply for advertising. Okay, a common base. Toothpaste is a common basic nature material. And the extra freshness, pudina, salt, Ayurveda, lots of things are there, that everything is only for advertising. Okay? Every toothpaste present in the market is simple what? Basic in nature. That's why it will neutralize the effect of the acid. Okay, that's why the parents and the doctors are saying that it is better to brush your teeth before going to bed. Okay, after having dinner. Okay, that much time is there, like 8 or 10 hours is there for the next breakfast, isn't it? So that is the time when the bacteria attacks our teeth. Actually, bacteria is not attacking the teeth, okay? Bacteria is only degrading the food particles in our mouth. And in that process, acid is released. That acid causes corrosion. That is tooth decay. Bacteria directly do not doing anything, okay? The best way to prevent tooth decay is to clean the mouth after eating food using toothpaste, which are generally basic for cleaning the teeth, can neutralize the excess acid and prevent tooth decay. So by using toothpaste, we can reduce the effect of tooth decay. See, how do the enamel undergo damage during eating of chocolates and sweets? What should be done to prevent it? Let's see. Tooth enamel is chemically calcium phosphate. That is the chemical formula of tooth enamel. Same like our bone. Okay, our bone is also calcium and phosphorus. Sugar present in chocolate and sweet gets broken to acids by bacteria present in our mouth. It starts corroding when pH falls below 5.5. Okay, that acid produced by this bacteria, that acid when its pH value is below 5 or below 5.5, it will start to corrode the enamel. Okay? Doctors advise to use paste to prevent tooth decay because they are alkaline and neutralize the acid portion. Alkaline means which dissolves in, actually it is base, but it dissolves in water. Okay? So that is the another application type of question from this chapter. Both are same. Next. If you have been got a sting by a bee or a wasp, okay, if you got a sting means that bees will, what is, they will poke us with their dislike thing, see, isn't it? It's heavily painful, am I right or not? It's heavily painful. If you get a sting from a honeybee or a wasp is also, not honeybee, but wasp is also another flying insect. its stinging is also very, very painful. Okay, in your home also there is a lots of wasp. They, it's not like honeybee, but they also have these types of spikes to sting us. Actually, what is it? That sting is actually acid. Okay, it contains a chemical inside that. That chemical causes that pain. And if we are getting a sting from a bee or honeybee or a wasp, what we want to do? Use a mild base like baking soda or toothpaste also is fine. Okay, toothpaste also is fine. If you are getting a sting, just apply some toothpaste there and leave it for a few seconds. Automatically the pain will go. Understand? Because the sting contains a chemical which is acidic in nature, and if we use basic natured materials like baking soda or washing soda or toothpaste which we are using, automatically what will happen? That pain will go. Mild base, you want to use mild base, don't use sodium hydroxide and all, okay? It will burn our skin. Kamala was playing in the garden. Okay, it's only application level question, I will give it afterwards, okay? So Kamala got stung by a wasp or a honeybee. So her mother applied toothpaste on the affected area. Why? Because it is basic in nature, so applying it on the affected area will neutralize the effect of the acidic wasp sting. Leave it. And this is another thing. Nettle plant, this is the local nettle plant. I don't know in your area this plant is available or not, but nettle plants are there in lots of areas. Okay, nettle plants, actually that sting, it is very, very irritating. Okay, we will feel highly irritated when we are getting stung by this nettle plant. And what we want to do? We want to apply some base get rid of that pain or irritation. We need to rub it with some base. Actually, dog plant, these plants are not in our local areas. Okay, it is mostly in the eastern part, western part, not in our area. Dog plant, anyway, I don't know if dog plant is there in our area or not. Nettle plants are available in our area. Okay, dog plants is also available in our these areas, tropical evergreen forest area in Kerala, this part. But in your part, I don't know they are available or not. Anyway, that is also acid, and whenever acid comes, what we want to do? You want to neutralize it with an alkali or a base. You can take the screenshot of this one. Okay, because it's an important thing. Some of the acid, most of them you already know. Vinegar, acetic acid, you know, citric acid, orange, lemon also citric acid. Milk, lactic acid, tamarind, tartaric acid, tomato, oxalic acid. Okay, this one also keep in mind. Today's quiz, I will ask these questions. Ant sting, methanoic acid, nettle sting also, methanoic acid. These acid causes pain and irritation. Understand? Methanoic acid. These are some of the acids we will study. We already studied in this chapter. Okay. Just imagine these ant sting and wasp sting will come with sulfuric acid. What will happen? Oh my God, we cannot even imagine that, isn't it? Okay, solution A, B, B, leave it. These are simple questions. Okay, some solutions are given. Questions will come like pH value is 6, pH value is 2, pH value is 13, pH value is 11, pH value is 8. Arrange them in ascending order, which is base or not. Automatically you know that below 7 it is acidic in nature, above 7 it is basic in nature. Okay, I think you are very much familiar with these types of questions. If it is come for exam, I am sure you will easily answer it. Okay, if the pH value is below 3, we can say it is strong acid. And if the pH value is above 12, we can say it is strong base. Okay, if the pH value is between 8 to 11, we can say it is weak alkali or weak base. And the pH value is between 4 to 6, we can say it is weak acid. Okay, you already know that pH is very, very easy, isn't it? That pH chart and everything is very, very easy. Okay, this is another question. The soil in our field is highly acidic. What we will use? Have you seen your parents or your neighborhood farmers using that shells? What is it? It's actually calcium carbonate, isn't it? Or calcium oxide also we can use. Magnesium oxide also we can use. If they are artificial fertilizers or some of them are bases. We are using it for what purpose? To neutralize the acidity of the soil. Okay, if this acidity of the soil is too much, crops cannot grow in that soil. Understand? That's why we are using these types of bases to reduce the acidity of the soil. Basically, these three bases we are using: calcium oxide, CaO, calcium carbonate, CaCO3, magnesium oxide, MgOH twice. Okay, so these are the three things. If you are writing the answers, try to write the chemical equation also. Okay, it is also good. Just study that chemical equation: calcium carbonate, CaCO3, calcium oxide, CaOH, calcium magnesium oxide, CaO, MgOH twice, like that. Okay, because if you write the answer with chemical equation, it is good. Without equation also, you will get the mark, but it's a good impression if you are writing that. Okay, that means the examiner who is checking your answer sheet, they will have a confidence. Okay, this kid, they know a lot. Understand? Okay. What is this importance of pH in our daily life? Let's see. Our body works within the pH range of 7.7 to 8. That means our human body is a bit basic in nature. Understand? When pH of rainwater is less than 5.6, it is called as acidic rain. 5.6, I think it is not correct. In some places, it is written 4.5. Anyway, one more time, I will clarify and I will tell it. I am not sure about this. In some textbook, I have seen 4.5. Some textbook, it is like 5.6. Anyway, the pH of the rainwater will reduce. You want to study this? Just leave this. Okay, in notes, I will give the correct answer, okay? I'm not sure about that. Lots of years ago, I read about this. When pH of rainwater is less than 5.6, it is called as acidic rain. Understand? Because there is a lots of oxides present in the atmosphere. Like sulfur oxide, nitrous oxide, isn't it? So that oxides will react with this rainwater and it will make it acidic in nature. And the acidity of that acid, a property of that rain is below, here it is 5.6, but I am not sure. If the pH is very low, means it is called as acidic rain. Acid produced in stomach which causes pain and irritation. You already know that. To get rid of this pain, people use antacid, mild base, like milk of magnesia. Tooth decay starts when pH of mouth is lower than 5.5. Using toothpaste, okay, you know that. Bee sting, you know that. Use of mild base, okay, no. Stinging hair, okay, all these things, you know. This is something new. Tanks in which milk is stored. That you don't have seen, but this thing you have seen. Milkman. Where is our milkman? Okay. Milkman adds a small amount of baking soda to fresh milk. What is the reason? Otherwise, it will become curd. Understand? Because small amount of lactic acid is present in the milk. Understand? Milk, see, pH of the fresh milk is from 6 to slightly alkaline, because in alkaline condition, milk does not set as curd. What is that? No. Milkman shifts the pH of the fresh milk from 6. Actually, the pH value of milk is below 7. Understand? Goat milk is almost 7, but the pH value of common milk is 6 to 7. Understand? So it is a slightly acidic in nature. So what will happen? Slowly, the lactic acids, the amount of lactic acid will increase and the milk will change into curd. To stop that, what the milkman is doing, he will add some base into it. Here he is using what? Baking soda, okay, small amount of baking soda, because baking soda is basic in nature, it will change the acid nature of milk into alkali nature, okay, or basic nature, so that it won't become curd. Same thing is happening here. Big containers of milk, have you seen the big containers of milk? That containers, inside that, what they are using? They are using sodium hydroxide solution. Okay, not concentrated. The tank of milk is cleaned by sodium hydroxide solution to keep the acidic nature neutralized. Understand? Anyway, within that notes, you study that. Okay, I'll give the notes. Simply reading, you will understand that. It is not that much very rocket science is not there behind this one. Check the solubility, distilled water for, it is another chart, only for your understanding. Okay. Some salt, sodium, potassium, nitrate, aluminum chloride, zinc sulfate, copper sulfate. Okay, anyway, all these things also you want, I will give the chart. You just read it. There is nothing to explain in this chart. Okay, some salt and how their pH. See, sodium chloride is neutral. Potassium nitrate is neutral. Aluminium chloride is less than 7 means acidic in nature. Zinc sulfate is less than 7 means acidic in nature. Copper sulfate is less than 7 means acidic in nature. Sodium acetate is greater than 7 means basic in nature. Sodium carbonate is also basic in nature, greater than 7. Sodium hydrocarbonate is also above 7 means basic in nature. And these are the acid and bases which we use to make them. Okay. To make which one? What is that? To make sodium chloride or salt, we can use hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. In the case of potassium nitrate, just read it, you will understand, okay? I will give that chart anyway. Okay, difference between acid and alkali, okay, that's also, just write the definition for them. Okay, alkalis are bases, understand? All alkalis are bases. Water soluble bases are called as alkalis. Base alkali, example also is there. Calcium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, their base sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, aluminum hydroxide is not soluble in water. That's why it is not given there, I think. Okay, leave it. That question will come. Next one is the rock salt. We are studying about sodium chloride. See, this one we will study in next class because it's very, very important. 5 more salts we want to study in this chapter, okay? 5 more salt. Because in this part which we studied, this is important, okay? Difference between acid and alkali. Difference between base and alkali. Okay, both 2 mark question. These are application level question. Okay, why milkman is adding baking soda to fresh milk? I think now you will understand the sense of that those questions. Understand, baking soda, what is it? It's a base. Why we are adding it to milk? Because milk is bit acidic. So, if the milk stays acidic, it will change into curd. So, it is very bad. Understand? Will you make a tea with a curd? Anyway, I won't do that. I don't know about you. I don't know how it tastes and all. I have never tried it. Okay, if you have time at your home, just try to make a tea with curd. Or what do you say? Majki, mazuru, I don't know. Or that buttermilk. You just use that buttermilk to make a cup of tea. Then you will understand how it feels. Anyway, milkman, he is wise. So, he is not doing that. Anyway, he is adding some, only small amount of base is required, okay? Only small amount, not a lot. If we add a lot, means what will happen? The taste of that milk will change. And you want to use mild bases. But in this case, it is not concentrated sodium hydroxide. They are using diluted sodium hydroxide solution they are using. Solution means it is diluted. So these are the main things about this part. Only some applications regarding acid, okay? Basically, these are the questions which will come from this chapter. We discussed almost all the questions. Okay, all the questions we already discussed. Some doubt is there regarding this acid rain's pH value. I will clarify it and I will send the message. Okay, this one, I have a doubt. I don't know if it is correct or not. I will check it one more time. Okay, everything which is written in study materials, sometimes they won't be correct. Anyway, I already checked this entire slide, but I didn't see in this one. My mistake anyways. Leave it. Anyway, I will clarify it and I will send it, okay? I will clarify it and I will confirm it and I will send the correct pH value. I think it is 4.5, but here it is like 5.6. Let me check one more time. So, that's it, my dear kids. One more class or 2 more class, we will end this chapter, okay? Monday or Tuesday, we will end this chapter. Only some applications. See, it's very, very interesting also. Very, very interesting, very, very easy. Okay, that's for next class. Today we don't have time. It will take 1 hour to complete this class. Means 2 more classes. Okay, nothing, it's nothing, only five salts are there in this chapter we want to study. It is about sodium chloride or rock salt. Next one is what? Bleaching powder, baking soda, baking powder, washing soda, and plaster of Paris. All are important. All are important for you. Okay, that's it. That's the end of this class. I am winding up. I hope you already understand. You must be able to gather this information you have studied about acids and bases, and you must be able to apply that in daily life. Okay, that type of question will come for examination. Anyway, for state board exam, that much twisty questions won't come. Okay, that much type of questions will be asked only for what? Asked only for CBSE. Okay, CBSE. Anyway, you are not CBSE, central board, you are not regarding central board. So, like that questions won't come. Anyway, we will try in daily quiz and all. I will try to make some twisty questions. Try to answer it. Okay. Some uses of hydrochloric acid, we will study it later. It's very, very interesting. See, daily using things, these all things are being made from the, see, baking powder we are using in our, what? In our kitchen. Soda, acid, fire extinguisher. This is for base, for digestion and all. Anyway, you see, the bread we are using, the dough we are using to make bread and all, chapati, bhaji, everything, everyday life. What all things we are doing in everyday life, that is we are going to study. Washing soda, washing powder we are using, isn't it? It's very, very important. Plaster of Paris and all, see, what are the use of plaster of Paris, see? Anyway, I am just wasting the time. Okay, that's it. I am winding the class up. So, yesterday I was a bit busy, so I cannot conduct that quiz today. I will try to conduct it because night time here, evening time, it will be heavy raining here. So mostly the network won't be there, electricity won't be there, and it is very difficult also. In between there is no rain, that's why I am taking this class now. Okay, some applications are there regarding all these things. I will try to finish this in one class. No, it won't finish in one class. It will take two class for that. Okay. So that's it, my little kids. Mithun Raj signing off from this part of the world. I hope all of you are healthy, feeling well, enjoying your studies. Okay. Enjoy your studies. That's the main thing. If you are not interested, stop it there. Do some excited things. Use some time for some games and all. Relax your mind and come back. Enjoy your study. That's the way to study science. Without that, there is no use. I think that this chapter is interesting, isn't it? Anyway, after this many years of teaching, I like to teach this chapter. It's a very interesting chapter. Each and every time when I am teaching, some new things are coming. See, for example, like this today. Past 5 or 6 years, we were doing this. But I have a doubt regarding this PH. Okay. Anyway, I will clarify and I will send. That's it. That's it for today. So, stay home, stay safe. When you are getting outside, what do you want to do? You want to wear mask. Okay. And maintain personal hygiene. Especially wash your hands properly. And whenever coming back to home from outside, take a bath. Okay. Take a clean bath. It is very, very good to kill the coronavirus and all. So, hope all are feeling happy, enjoying your life. So, bye bye, my dear kids, signing off from this part of the world. Okay, bye bye and Jai Hind. Next class, we will go with the applications of that salt. Okay, bye bye.